Hello and welcome back, guys. It's Chicago Ted with another installment of the Golden Aegis Cast Series. This match was sent in by a lovely donator and is going to be the match ID 16374956668. So thank you to who donated here. I've since given up saying who's been donating for each game because it leaves a pretty heavy impact on knowing who might win the game if you can tell who was a donator by what's their name is here. So I've stopped with that. Instead, I'm going to put it in the description of the video when I get to it. Either way, thank you for joining me thus far. If you're watching live or going to be watching this on a replay, I hope you enjoy the show. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get rolling. Drop down on free camera, and then let's go. So, for the Radiant side of this match, it is going to be Ashka Asura on the Bloodseeker, Taliban on the Drow Ranger. Scared will be playing the Nature's Prophet, Zachary on the Phantom Lancer, and Breen on the Bounty Hunter. Meanwhile, for the Dire side, it's going to be Cutie Vomit Girl on the Techies, Hazardous on the Lion, I can't even read that, Sherbart on the Magnus, I guess Sherbert, Purge on the Puck, and Tits McGee playing the Tinker. It looks like Techie's mining the top rune. Kind of an awkward sort of place for him to be as, yeah, that just happens. So he's taking a little bit of damage from this. Doesn't seem like he cares. Alright, we're going to have a relocate in. Scared, TPing to the bottom rune spot. And away we'll grab the bottom rune top. Looks like it'll go the way of Hazardous as Taliban doesn't want to walk over those mines. And I mean, kind of a weird way to start out this game. Techies, though. We'll go ahead. It looks like he's going to mine up the top lane. Even though they've got a tri lane, they have a mid laner. Sherbert, what's he doing up? I'm not totally sure I understand, but regardless, it looks like a quad lane for the top. Cutie is going to be up here trying to drop some mines out. A Bloodright goes down, but not really doing too much right now, especially at the early stages. And I'm pretty sure these guys, Breen, Nashka, Asura, might be just as confused as I am. Taliban, though, gets an absolute free lane to farm, which, by and large, is one hell of a free lane. I mean, Drow getting far ahead, free farm, not missing a single CS as ideally would be quite a lane. So it looks like Hazardous is going to bite the bullet and go towards mid and start to try to put some harass on the Taliban here. But Tits McGee is also going down, so this quad lane is finally breaking up. The band has seen their differences and will now go off and do their own duos here. And it's going to be Tits and Hazardous in towards the mid lane. Though Hazardous, I think, is going to be more of a roaming kind of support here. And Cutie, as well as Sherbert, up here in the top to solo it out. Cutie's still mining up this top lane as if it might work for him. It looks like he's got a couple because of this weird highlight. But, oh, Ashka Asura! Looks like he wanted to walk over. He was going to, and then, well, decided last second to dodge it out there. So the amount of times they've gotten this close, and I assure you I'm putting my hands up like and showing like a small distance this close to the mines breaking up. Like over here, the Drow Ranger walked well within proximity, and up there in the top, the Bloodseeker. But they know that he's mining there. I'm pretty sure they have every idea that he's mining there. Breen, though, if he gets a little bit careless, he might end up walking over it. And this tri-lane, not really going to net up that many kills. I think they're waiting for Magnus to go ahead and try for the skewer in onto these mines. And he probably could have had both there, but his skewer is only level 1, so his distance is not that big. It's 750, so probably around this range here. Meanwhile, Scared, taking a bit of safe lane farm from Zachary. Not sure where this lane is supposed to be. Maybe Zachary, or maybe, Scared should be in the jungle, or was going to be in the jungle, but I guess decided not to. Whatever the case is there. It's pretty interesting lanes all about. I mean, I think I've seen multiple things I don't think I've ever seen before, and, you know, I guess you learn something new every day, and regardless, Sherbert up top is doing all right with farm. I mean, all right being 5CS. The top, though, is still Taliban, as expected, having that completely safe lane for a good amount of time. Is level 4, almost 5 now, and should be looking at having the precision aura up very soon, a marksmanship rather, up very soon, giving lots of damage to both her as well as a couple of her teammates, being only the Nature's Prophet. But, you know, Nature's Prophet with some extra damage is still a pretty scary thing to have to go up against. So looks like Zachary taking the most of the farm and not really just shrugging off this harass that Purge has seemed to be giving out to him. It looks like a double damage will be taken by Scared, and that'll be it. He's actually started with a bottle too, which is very interesting coming out from this Nature's Prophet. Not something that I've seen before, but at the same time, could definitely work here. And it looks like he's using it just to lane, which, as we said, this is a laning Nature's Prophet, not anything like a jungle or along those lines, so. He's gonna go up, he's gonna hit the phase shift. Waning Rift does not have Illusory Orb, and Scared isn't gonna pop that double damage. Instead, gonna hold on to it. Figures he could use it for a later date. So Puck will get away, not taking too much damage on top of it. And 4.5 minutes in, no kills have happened on the board. Though there are plenty of techies mines. He's got, okay, this one I have to see.
That's a first blood.
So that happens. The Drow Ranger will go down to Taliban, and I'm sorry, Taliban will go down to Tits McGee. A kind of casual kill there, but the Drow Ranger kept herself low, which opened herself up to this massive burst of the laser, and I guess, you know, not really respecting the damage that it does there. Unfortunately, we'll be taken down by that, and that will be First Blood. Just as I was saying, First Blood hasn't happened yet. Hazardous now, trapping too. The Suicide will come out, and Bloodseeker will be brought down because of it. Breen, though, still sort of alive. He wants to throw an extra stun. And if he can blindly throw one out and line it up correctly, he might be able to just grab a kill, but it looks like the Bounty Hunter getting himself far enough away that that won't be a problem. Purge, meanwhile, still farming all right in the bottom lane. He's got 11 CS, so he's doing just about as well as Zachary, which is kind of interesting for the Puck here. Nature's Prophet still having that double damage rune, and we're still seeing the Walking Courier on the Radiant side. Difficulties. Taliban, meanwhile, looking to try to put some harass on that Tits McGee, but really not able to stay within range. Has 3 points in those Frost Arrows, so looking more for damage and chase. Meanwhile, Breen at the top lane, they're going to skewer him back and do plenty of damage to him, but it's going to be Asuka Asura that just kind of runs in and ransacks. He's looking for Sherbert as well. Breen will go down to Sherbert, but Asuka Asura, he walks over the mines! Techies! Techies, 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 techies. Bottom lane, Purge will go down, Zachary, and Scared will be happy to bring him down. Another double damage rune. It's been 6 minutes, and we've already seen two of them. Jeez, that's pretty incredible. Vomit Girl is going to have her blood, the Soul Ring out. Coming on the courier, the Walking Courier.
Dyer's mid-tower won't last much longer.
In 6.5 minutes, you really kind of want to have that Flying Courier for either team. I mean, even if you're not a support, buying the Flying Courier is absolutely pivotal. Sometimes you have to do things that you don't quite want to do. Taliban, a lot of trouble, but Purge not quite following it up correctly and doesn't drop the Dream Coil either. Had a little bit of extra damage that she could have spent that she actually didn't, and unfortunately, that will lose her a kill. In the meantime, Scared goes up and starts the Cliff Jungle. Guys, what's going on?
Radiant's mid tower's getting banged up.
This is quite the game coming so far, right?
The Dire best do something.
So Scared,
about bottom tower.
Cliff jungling, looking for that Midas, or I guess power treads would make a little bit more sense.
Radiant's
in the context.
Mid tower could use a hand.
Asker, Asura, also probably going for those power treads. Hazardous, not really that much, but Sherbert, level 5. Looks like they're gonna go ahead and try to chase him this, but. Breen not going for the slow, so they're not actually able to chase any further on. Scared, meanwhile, again, cliff jungling. Purge looks like he wants Exactly. Now he'll go for the Illusory Orb, and he actually hits it. And he goes with a Dream Claw as well, and Exactly goes down. Purge, this time, gets it perfectly. And will grab a quick and easy kill. And brings down the Phantom Lancer. That's very good for the puck. So very well played. Meanwhile, where's our Nature's Prophet at?
Radiant's
he was Cliff Jungler. Okay, now he's back. Goes for... Still doesn't have the power treads, especially after taking that camp. Kind of interesting coming out. Taliban, meanwhile, going for a Vladimir's Offering. A pretty good item nowadays, now that the it hits onto range as well as melee auto-attacks. And the damage boost is really good, too, considering Drow, being an agility hero, gets a lot of base damage. A percentage-based damage increase item, like a Vlad's, is actually pretty damn good on her. So she'll be able to lifesteal up pretty easily, even with Frost Flareholes. And I mean, even now, with just the Morbid Mask, she's lifestealing up pretty effectively, going through what little damage or what damage the Tinker has to throw at her. And Exactly will make his way back down bottom. Scared is there as well, but Sherbert might be in a little bit of trouble. Blood right on the ground, it won't connect. They have the Impale or the Air Spike coming out from Hazardous, but it won't connect. And Scared is actually up here. He wants Sherbert, looking for one or two more auto attacks, but the Hex comes in and Scared could actually drop here. One more auto attack is all he needs, but the Impale or the Air Spike comes out. And Hazardous will take Scared's life. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Exactly wants Purge, but Purge might actually be the one to grab the kill here. He needs one more Illusory, but doesn't have the mana for it. We'll go ahead, cancel that salve, though. And that'll be all she wrote for the time being. Tits McGee comes down. Oh, he could grab a kill here. And he will. In come the Rockets from the back. And it looks like he went for the Doppelganger, or at least tried to cast it, but didn't get it quite in time. Very unfortunate, but the PO will go down. Tinker, quite happy to deliver it.
Dire's mid tower could use a little help.
So just going to farm around the map right now. Both teams are right to do so. And, I mean, Taliban is actually getting a lot out of it. Where is he standing on the... Oh, Rockets come through. Tits McGee wants to try to do something here, but actually might be him in a lot of trouble. He turns. He wants the laser. Gets it off. And Vomical is there as well. Looking for a suicide, but it's still on cooldown. Is that Tranquil Boots for the techies? That's quite interesting. I guess in terms of move speed, it's pretty good. Meanwhile, he'll get a kill on Bounty Hunter. Looks like it was the rune. So those mind stacks in the rune finally pay off. And I don't think he knows it scares there. Maybe if he checked for the experience. But Taliban will go for the chase. Bloodrite doesn't connect. They avoid the mines. And Vomit Girl on the run. But the Hazardous is in. Looking for the Air Spike. Actually just turns and fingers Drow. Taliban being taken down. Air Spike comes through but doesn't connect. Sherbert now wanting to chase. He's got Skewer but not using it. Shockwave as well. He's going to throw it out. Will not connect. Meanwhile, Breen is coming in. Looking for a bit of a return kill on the aggressive Magnus, but there's no one really to help him follow up. And
Radiant's top tower.
Looks like Sherbert will get away with nothing more than a slap on the wrist and a track on the back. Vomit, meanwhile, might Radiant's be in a little bit more trouble. Mining up the secret shop. Well under vision, though. They've got Blood Rite. And it will stun him out. Sherbert back into this one. And what the mines! They bring down another kill. Breen might be in a little bit of trouble as well. Sherbert turning and fighting. He's got the RP, but doesn't want to spend it. Meanwhile, in comes Scared, looking for Vomit Girl, who's going to end up denying herself. Or himself, or itself. Sherbert could drop here. He's got the bottle, but ends up getting taken down. Scared, quite happy to be able to say he killed him. And Schnurbert will hit the grave. 6-10 right now at 12 minutes. So far, I mean, no one really leading the pack. I guess if you look at net worth, a Tinker is at the top, but not pulling away that fast and still pretty adequately farming. 3,500 net worth at 12 and a half minutes, Hazardous. If he finds Breen, he's underneath the sentry ward. Hazardous does not have a finger, but he does have an Earth Spike. He does have a hex. But Breen will get himself away from this. Meanwhile, how's Asuka Asura doing? He's 1-3 on this Bloodseeker, even though he's had a couple of really deep engagements, and it seemed like he was starting to pull away. He has fallen back quite a bit. Purge going up against two, though. Rupture comes out, and it looks like Purge, he's as good as dead here. Sherbert's in, trying to help him out. We'll go for the RP, but he is very low on damage, and he can't quite follow up with that alone, so he won't get any kills off of that one, and instead his RP will just be sent on cooldown. Meanwhile, as that was happening, it looks like Tits McGee did go down to Taliban here in the mid lane, who is very close, if not at, the Vladimir's offering if she wants it.
That's four.
And Bounty Hunter again, dying to the mind stack. It leads you to wonder how many times it's going to actually happen in this game. So as it stands right now, 8-11. I won't pin anyone with a clear advantage. It seems like they might be evenly distributed right now, and it pretty much is about 1,000 net worth advantage and experience to the Radiant, 1,000 to the Dire. For gold to the late Radiant, 1,000 experience to the Dire. So pretty even. In the mid lane, Puck will go ahead and bring down Taliban. Looks like he wanted to bring down Tits McGee, but being surrounded by 3 or 4 is definitely not a safe situation for any drow. Meanwhile, Exakary dies to a neutral creep. Maybe trying to farm it a little aggressively or whatnot, but he'll go down there. Purge gonna grab himself an illusion rune and make his way back to lane, but the mid tier 1 tower Radiant's should take some damage here. It actually should go down here. They continue to push this one out. Meanwhile, Breen can first Radiant farm here. He wants to go ahead and bring down Purge, who's gonna actually Radiant's Illusion Rub and Waning Rift on nothing. Sherbert, meanwhile, comes back behind Asuka Asura. Does he have an RP? He doesn't. 20 seconds. Meanwhile, Techies comes in mid. He will get the tower kill, and that'll be it.
Dire's top tower, you know the drill.
So TP in coming in from Exakary after having the shame of going down to a neutral creep. Makes his way back into the lane. But he's going to walk over mines.
Top tower's getting beat.
A lot of mines. He's not careful. And it's actually going to be Asuka Asura. Nope, exactly. No. Who's it going to be?
Trouble brewing at Radiant.
Who's it going to be to die by the mines? Is it going to be Breen? It's going to be both. Oh, Exakary is in close by. Fisher and Shockwave. No, he's just going to right click him down. So two kills for those mines. Meanwhile, Tits McGee will go ahead and bring down Taliban with the help of Hazardous. It looks like they spent the finger of death on that one as well, but that's a quick three kills going the way of the Dire. And what seems like them starting to pull away in this game. Now they do have a Techies, which means being ahead with the Techies, that's where you want to be. Falling behind with the Techies, okay, well now you got a turtle. But being ahead with the Techies allows you to mine aggressively and continue to find kills and do hectic things
Radiant
across the map.
Tower ain't a pretty sight right now. Radiant's
looks like,
toughened up
as far as rune mines go, the Techies Vomit hasn't really been dropping these, continuing to drop these mines, even though they've been very successful up to this point. And where is Techies mining right now? It looks like it will go for it. Now, he's level 8, not bad at 16 and a half minutes, and he will skyrocket if he can continue to get these kills on across the map.
Seen better days.
The bottom tier 1 will go down, Purge will bring it down.
Towers.
A lot of tier 1s, they're kind of falling like dominoes right now. One down for the Dire, two down for the Radiant. And what's this? Hazardous spotting out a farming Taliban. But not able to do too much about it. Meanwhile, Cutie is just farming up. He's going for that that Yule Scepter. And that'll help out. Just be very aggressive. Try to fight. Try to do what you can around the map, as well as be able to drop mines anywhere and everywhere you want. But Dire, they're pretty aggressively positioned right now. And for how aggressively positioned they are, they're not really taking that many fights. More or less just being there, being a presence on the map. And Exakary, meanwhile, trying to push the bomb tier 1 tower, but in comes Tits McGee, able to go ahead and clear this push with pretty much one cast of Martian Machines. Meanwhile, Vomit and Hazardous make their way down bottom. They will be spotted out by Breen. He throws a track, so they know that they've been spotted. but Hazardous will continue chasing. Unfortunately for him, Ashka Asura throws out the Blood Ray behind. They've also got Exactly. They're going to go ahead and rupture out Hazardous. Now he can turn around to get a three-man Impale or Earthspike, but it's not going to be enough to save his life. In comes Scared, looking for some more. Since McGee on the run, though, a Sprout comes out and locks him in place, but can they exactly bring him down? It looks like the Sprout won't last long enough, and Tits will get away. In the meantime, though, Schnurber comes in, wants the RP. Can he find it? Looks like he backs himself off and won't actually get it. Meanwhile, a couple of mines up here by the Tier 1 tower. Just making sure that even if they do lose a fight here, if they back off, whenever the Radiant tries to push again, they will face some pretty dire consequences. So double Blood Right hits, Tismaki and Schubert both being hit by a Sprout will lock Schubert in place for the RP down dead in center, and it looks like he will still go down, but brings everyone low with him. Tismaki also pretty low. Does Exactly chase on this? Does he have any Phantom Lance? Does he have anything at all? The remote mines have got to be careful, bring down two! Tits McGee will still fall, but Vomit Girl bringing a double kill.
The dog best do something about that bottom tower.
That's just painful. Exactly, though, in the meantime, we'll go ahead and just drop some damage onto the bottom tier 2 tower, bottom tier 1 tower. Should be able to bring it down on his own. The backstab from Hazardous, though. Does he have anything to stop this? He does have a finger of death, but can't tell which one's 0-1.
Right,
Exactly, in the meantime, we'll go ahead, bring down this tier 1 tower, and that'll be it. Hazardous now goes in with the Impale. Does he have a finger of death? He uses it, but immediately, Exactly goes ahead with the Doppelganger, and then turns around Spirit Lance. Could he actually bring down Exactly? They've got remote mines. They don't pop him. And they can't quite chase Exactly either. Meanwhile, Schnurbert will kill Scared. An interesting aggressive teleport coming in from Scared. Meanwhile, Exactly still chasing on the Purge, or rather Purge still chasing onto Exactly, but he's gonna end up dropping for this. They've got the Rupture and they will bring him down. So 20 minutes, Dire having 20 kills to the 12 of the Radiant. Meanwhile, Tits McGee, he's got a Void Stone. Is he going for a potentially a Yule Scepter of his own? I guess would be pretty good. I like Yule Scepter on Tinker. It's a decent item. 20 and a half minutes in, though. No really instance of sign of any team getting the objective advantage. Both teams taking fights and farming, but not really pushing and not really going too hard on taking any sort of towers, Roshans, anything like that. Scare is going to try to jungle, but 6 seconds, he's going to have to endure this Marching Machines. Looks like, yeah, he doesn't take that much damage from it. It is a level 2 March. Okay, so level 2 March, not ultimately doing that much to him. Meanwhile, Techies putting some remote mines up in the Ancient Pit. And Ashka might spot him out here. He's got to be careful about this. If he reveals the fact that he's mining here, he might be in a little bit of trouble. Those mines probably get dewarded, but looks like he's going to go pretty much unobstructed. And it looks like he might find his kill. Taliban walking over them. And there's a kill. Techies, quick and easy. So the pings come out, but the damage has been done. Taliban is gone, and the Tier 2 free to be pushed if they want to. But Vomikoro is continuing to mine the same spot. I think he was spotted out by the Bounty Hunter, though, which is a real problem, because they know he's still mining that spot. Purge, though, gonna go ahead. Wayne rifts off. Breen, that gets hexed up. Do they have any way to bring him down? They do, but in comes Ashka Asura. Waning Rift comes in, Purge trying to get himself away, a Rupture hits onto Tits McGee, and Ashka Asura will go down in the meantime. Ends up being a 3-for-1 in the end. Scared, though, could end up going down as well. They've got plenty of damage, and they'll bring him down. This is when you should push the Tier 2, but it looks like they're going to hold back for now. Vomit Girl, in the meantime, has dropped all the mines she wanted to, at least 2 mines. And now we'll go ahead, grab the haste, and that'll be it. lot of damage coming out from those mines, though. A lot of damage. Silence coming out from Taliban. Not really hitting on anyone. 8 seconds before it's back up again. And Dire, they're grouped around this wave. Maybe they want to push, but so far they're doing it rather slowly. Vomigirl has gone back to mining the Ancient Pit. And just like that, Perch TPing back to base. And everyone else just being quite passive about this game. Both teams struggling to find their farm. I mean, net worth is only about 6,000 at its max at 23 minutes. And it looks like maybe we see a fight. Breen goes out for the track but doesn't find anyone. Yeah, gold per minute is just shy of 290 for each person in this map. I mean, for these guys, you kind of want to be aiming for about 350 to 400, so there's some farm that could be happening that isn't happening, and maybe for the team to turn the tides in this match, they need to take a step back and farm a little bit more, getting some items out and winning the game off the back of that. I mean, objectives are great. Objectives will help you out with that. And mines, maybe. Breen walking over them. The mines will come out. Hazardous now going for the impale. And here come the mines. They bring down Taliban. Magnus will then grab a double kill with the RP scum shockwave. And again, Dire pulling out a really good fight. Radiant kind of left in the dust a little bit. But it looks like maybe we see a kill. Scared going in for Tits McGee. But again, this aggressive teleport in ends up netting nothing. And now the rockets come out. And they stop Scared where he stands. Another four dead and Dire. I mean, I almost want to say go back to farming, but at the same time, I think this tier 2 tower is right for the picking, as well as the top tier 1. Plenty of gold just sitting on the map for them, ready to take, ready to absorb into their bank accounts. For right now, they're just holding back. They're playing it very safe, and I mean, almost a bit too safe right now. Where are we mining right now for Vomit here? Still has those Ancients mined up, so whenever someone happens to walk past those, they probably will get blown up immediately. And recently, it has been Taliban who has been the one to kind of walk past that area, but I think once burnt, twice shy is what really happens here. Is she's kind of afraid to go walking off alone right now. And that's what happens when you lose a little bit of map control to a techies, is you end up having parts of your map get mined up that even though you think you have some map control, you try to move around, try to expand your wings, and then one of your feathers touches a mine and you're just dead. So little mines here and there. It looks like Purge wants to make his way in. Waning Rift immediately will drop down with a Dream Coil, but only hits on the Breen. In come the Rockets. Breen taking a lot of damage from it. In comes the Finger of Death as well. Hazardous. Happy to bring him down. Now hexing up Taliban with the Earth Spike. Purge looking for some right clicks as well, but don't quite have enough damage to bring him down. Purge goes way too far ahead. And now Taliban healing himself back up. All he needed was one more auto attack, but couldn't get it off. Meanwhile, Exactly. It's split pushing out the bottom lane. And for one is what it ends up being. Plenty of damage going either way. Exactly. Oh, looks like he walked over a mine stack here. But staying alive. 200 HP. Schubert trapped in the trees.
Radiant top tower.
Still alive. Well alive, rather. And just like that, we'll back off again. Not really looking for too much here.
Radiant's top tower's hurting.
Both the Radiant and the Dire. Gonna go back, do what they can, what farming they can. 27 minutes in, the score is 50 to 29. And I mean, looking at right now, the Techies is doing really well. Like, you've got the Yule Scepter, you're getting very close to that either Bloodstone or my personal favorite, the Octarine Core. And that's really good. Like, she's regenning up a decent amount, doing pretty well in this game. Just gets a double kill. That's that Ancient stack we were talking about. Gets Ashka, Asura, and Exactly. Both guys who have been struggling to find what they can. Radiance PL. Alright. Taliban walking up to the high ground, walking past the mine stack, but not over it. They're going to go for a dream coil. And that Taliban taking a lot of damage will end up going down. Purge still alive, but they have the track in. He's going to bottle himself up and be able to blink himself away in the meantime. And meanwhile, Vomit Girl is going back, mining up this bottom tier 2 tower so Zachary can't pull any split push off. And Scared, might be in a lot of trouble. Hazardous has a finger of death and will not hesitate to bring him down. Meanwhile, Schnurbert goes and brings down Breen. And Dire, again, have a huge amount of advantage that they can try to push with. And the pings will come out to, it looks like, for the Radiant to defend their tier 2 tower. Dire's just going to probably get it. They no reward to defend it unless they glyph it. But even if they glyph it, I think Radiant can hang in close. Now, Levitt comes out, as well as Eruptur. And Schubert may be going to be the poster child of why I'm wrong here. A Hex out comes out for Ashka Asura. Rupture still down. And now Asura going to go ahead and chase. But the Impale, the Earth Spike comes through. Hazardous doing very well getting these stuns off. And now an RP comes out. Exactly is revealed. Can they bring him down? They can bring him down, but at the cost of their Magnus. And Taliban close by now has come back. And might be looking to bring down Tits McGee. But it'd be a slow effort, if at all. So he's going to move forward, maybe try to find a couple of kills here, maybe get some vengeance out. Meanwhile, Vomit is again going after this Ancient Pit. Kind of interesting, though, blowing up her own mines. And still where she's at, been at for a while. Breen, meanwhile, doing that as well, farming up as much as he can. He's got a... It looks like he's going for a Desolator, but he's already got the Urn of Shadows too, which is really great for him to have. Scared. Maelstrom probably on the way for him. Vomit, again, we've looked at her. Hazardous. Has that Blink Dagger and a mechanism, so this Lion, by all means, is doing very well. Purge, also with a Blink Dagger. Taliban's looking alright. Still hasn't finished that Vlad's. In fact, hasn't even started finishing it. It's just, you know, left it as the Morbid Mask in the headdress. Not really caring. Meanwhile, Ashka Asura has gone for a Maelstrom, and now with going towards that Blade Mail. So as it stands right now, you know, everyone kind of settling into their place. Exactly, still going for that Radiance, and he's getting very close to it, but I still am not totally sure this is the item. I mean, PL, when he was able to send illusions out on their own and have them sustain for a long time, that's when Radiance was really good. But nowadays, I mean, now the illusions die so quickly, Radiance almost becomes redundant. I mean, it's like building Radiance on any other hero. It's got no special farming purpose, it's got no special practical purpose, it's just there. Scared, taking a lot of damage. Purge will bring him down, though. Now Scared, hitting the drain. It looks like Purge can just go ahead and TP himself out of here. In comes Ashka. Asura didn't have vision of him, so wasn't quite able to see him around. Meanwhile, Vomit will go ahead back to mining up this jungle. Ashka moving pretty quickly, though. About 394 MS. Oh, I didn't know this existed. That's pretty cool. I guess that's more useful than what I had before. Anyway, Hazardous goes in. They're going to go ahead. He gets ruptured, though. Ashka Asura is there, and they've got him silenced, so he can't do anything about this. Just gets taken out. Tits McGee will continue to chase on this one. But Ashka Asura is pretty much as good as out. No, Sherbert's in. RP. They've got lots of damage. They could bring down Breen right here, but they don't know he's there. Meanwhile, Zachary going to be pushing out the bottom lane, but he's got to be careful of these remote mines that are down here. A double damage in the bottom moon spot, meanwhile. And Scared goes after the mid-tier 1 tower. Now, if he walks anywhere close to those mines, he's in a lot of trouble, but looks like they can just be able to take it out, no problem. Meanwhile, the Radiance does get finished. Tits McGee going to go in on the Scared. Now they silence him back, push him back. In comes Purge, though, going for the Waning Rift, and now they grab Taliban with that Dream Coil. He runs away and takes too much damage from the Exodus of it, and will be brought to justice here. Scared? With a double damage rune, will start to try to run away. He's got the Hand of Maya suspend, and... Well... Okay. We knew that was going to happen. So, Scared should be able to get himself out of there. quite easily. Meanwhile, Breen and towards the mid lane.
Tower's in bad shape.
We'll go ahead. What does he have? He's going. He's getting close again to that Desolator. And oh no, a Bloodstone. Oh, I can't say I like this. But whatever, I guess. To each his own here. Hazardous and Schnurbert coming towards the mid lane. They look for Breen. They just finger him. Mobile colonoscopy, courtesy of Hazardous. They'll bring down the bounty hunter, and with that, maybe they'll finally go ahead and get this tier 2 tower.
Radiance mid tower.
Bottom lane, same thing. Putting a little bit of pressure on it, but the glyph gets spent.
Radiant structures now.
Elabon farming under the tier 2. In comes Schubert. Goes straight on in for it, but gets silenced on back. Hazardous now goes in. Gets the Earth Spike. Can try to go for the Hex now, but a Rupture comes out onto Schnurbert. Hazardous is dedicated now to saving the life of his Magnus. Tismigi comes on in. Does he have a laser? He does. And Asuka, he'll go down in the meantime. Skurd trying to go for the Sprout, but the Lincoln Sphere blocks it off immediately. He continues to chase, but he might actually be dead here. Gets hexed up. Do they have a Shockwave? Do they have a Skewer? They've got everything they need, and they'll bring him down. Dire, pound for pound, are doing so damn well, but they have to push. They'll lose all this advantage if they don't push it out. I mean, even now, as I said, I don't quite like the Radiance on the PL, but you're letting him farm, and this could be a problem 10, 15 minutes down the road if you don't push. But they'll back off, go back to base, and then call it a day. I don't like this at all.
Just then, the Radiant disowned their mid tower.
So tier 2 will finally go down. It ends up going down to deny. Meanwhile, Roche still standing. Two tier 2s still standing on the Radiant, and a tier 1. And easy to kill tier 1 as well. They could just waltz right up there and start right-clicking it down. Bring it down almost immediately, but opting not to. There's still a mind stack over on the Ancients. A little bit of a mind stack on the Dire side here. Another Exactory killer. I guess Rat Trap is what I'll call him here. Kind of a random landmine up here. But it looks like maybe we see the fight happening in mid. There's going to be a Blood Rite hitting the ground. But just like that, nothing much coming of it. Looks like Hazardous is going to go forward. Balls of the Walls. Hex is up onto Taliban. Needs to get more here, but they don't quite have enough damage. Eruption now onto Hazardous. They're going to go for the RP, and they solidify Breen underneath the Sentry Ward. Can he bring down Hazardous? Does not look like it, but he's getting close. Hazardous gets brought down. Exactory's into this one now. And now he's got pretty much a carte blanche. There's no one here to stop him. They don't have anything for this. He's going to go in and continue to just try to chase this down and bring him down. Magnus will go down, but the suicide will finally end Exactory's spree. Scared on the high ground, we'll start right-clicking on Tismigee. And he's trying to run away from this one. Goes down with a Martian Machine, scared taking a little bit of damage from it, but not all that much. But I think Tismigee gets away here. Scared, gonna go ahead. Leap on forward, Tismigee walking right on into him. Tries for the Sprout, gets immediately lasered. 5 seconds, and he could turn around and maybe kill him here. Doesn't have the mana, though. He casted Rearm, but oh no, he might be in a little bit of trouble. Tries for the rockets, doesn't get it off, just gets out of vision. And laser does not come fast enough. Unfortunate maneuver by the Tinker there, as he does end up going down. Looks like Purple, he wanted to go and get a return kill onto the PL or the Nature's Prophet, but wasn't quite able to find him in time. No Dream Coil ready to be spent either, so. He does end up having a Dagon level 2, though, which is some decent intelligence coming out from him. As Taliban and Asuka are up in the top lane. Looks like that top tier 1 tower did end up going down, whether deny or otherwise. Puck probably destroying it, so yeah, it will go down, but still a couple of tier 2s left on the map. And, I mean, with the advantage that Radiant or the Dire has, I mean, 7,500 gold, about 20,000 experience. The only reason they're not that ahead in gold is because of this PL farming pretty well, but I mean, they've got so much advantage right now that they really need to try to exert it, you know, whether it be a push or otherwise. They have to try to get an objective and to win this game, because 20 minutes down the road, when they're going up against a six-slotted PL, a six-slotted Drow Ranger, a six-slotted Bloodseeker, a six-slotted Nature's Prophet, and a six-slotted Bounty Hunter, they don't win that fight. Even with a Techies defending their high ground, they don't have any real sustained physical damage. They just have a bunch of nukers, they have a bunch of utility heroes, they've got a bunch of decent fight, but no sustained physical damage to back it up. So they've got to figure out how to do something, and they got to do it fast. Otherwise, this game could go on for a while and could end in either an upset or just one hell of a long game. Still, we're 28-46. Not a lot of structure to a lot of the fights that are happening. But still, fights are happening and kills are breaking out. Techies, where is he mined right now? He's got some mines up here. Seven remote landmines in the map. He's got these remote mines still by the Ancients. Looks like Hazardous, he wants to kill the Taliban. Wins forward, but in comes the immediate rupture out from Ashka Asura. And he will get canceled. The Dreamcrow will stop him from moving for a short bit. But Taliban is just laying into Hazardous. He'll bring him down. Tits McGee can't quite do anything about it. Now finally he's able to do something. Purge. Meanwhile, it's actually Tits McGee to bring down Ashka Asura. Maybe they can push into tier 3s here. The bottom tower, they've got the mines, but they're not going to pop them. Oh, man, that's really unfortunate. Come on, come on. Breen's literally walking back and forth over them. Kill him! Do it!
That's what's happening at the Dire's bottom tower. Radiant's mid tower's getting banged up.
That was close. They definitely could have won the game right there.
Radiant's mid tower.
They still can. If they can, you know, lure them back, they could easily win this game. But Sherlock comes in. He's going to force them back. And by doing so, he might actually kill them. Because Scare's going to walk over them. The mines! Oh. Rather unfortunate here. Trying to stop him from getting away, but the Waning Rift is not going to be near enough. And so, that fight will kind of fizzle out here. None of the racks actually going down. None of the towers actually going down. And Dire, despite having a great advantage off that, were not able to solidify their advantage by grabbing any racks or any objectives there. Rather unfortunate, again, for the Dire team that they're not really pushing these objectives, but they're putting a lot of faith in their ability to continue this dominance, and it might not be the smartest idea. Who knows? We're 40 minutes into this game, and they've yet to take a rack, despite being up 20 or so kills. Now Taliban's got that Shadowblade, and they can't grab the kill on her anymore. That's one thing that they're losing out on now. It's slowly happening, but surely their ability to just run around and find a kill wherever they want is slowly starting to deplete. Tits McGee, though, comes up, maybe wants to try to find a kill here. If he gets picked off, though, this could be a problem. They've got the remote mines down. They could pop him. They will get a kill because of it. Now they got to follow up on the Taliban Ashka Asura. They got the rupture on Sherbert, and now Ashka goes up onto him. We'll go ahead and bring him down. Meanwhile, a Yule Scepter up on a Taliban. There is going to be a stasis trap, but did it end up not ending up finishing? It looks like it didn't end up finishing on its cast, so Taliban just turns around and starts right-clicking onto everyone. Tits McGee in a little bit of trouble, and in comes Taliban again, just doing enough damage to bring him down. And just like that, after 20 or 30 minutes, the Radiant, they take a positive fight.
You know the drill.
Get a 4-for-2 and a whole metric load of gold.
Dire's top tower's getting beat down.
I mean, take a look at the graphs, and yeah, the net worth is going to start rising up. The experience is also starting to rise up just a little bit. So more fights like that, and the Radiant could end up bringing this game down to a close, but Dire is still not out of it yet. They still have the lead. Purge, though, is going to get brought down. Vomit Girl as well might be taken out as well, trying to run, trying to hide. getting chased by Taliban and Exactly.
I might want to mine their top
Looks tower. Like they won't continue, and they're not going to go after the tier threes. Everyone's down on the Dire, and they could easily grab at least a tier three tower here.
You know the drill.
But Exactly decides he doesn't want it. Oh, man. It's rather disappointing for them, but, you know. Playing it really safe, I think they've got the much better late game, so I guess at this point, playing it safe and not really in any rush to end it. So, Radiant will group themselves up, going after the easier objective, which is the mid-tier 2 tower, but they could just all die to mines here. In fact, they might all do it right now. Oh man, they spread out and they go around the mines, but the mines will pop. And it looks like Scared will end up going down, but they're gone. Ashka, Sura ends up running away, even though all the mines are gone. Okay, he's going to run back in. Drops the blood right. Will not connect on anyone. And it looks like that's going to be their call to back off here. As it is, going to go in. Goes to the Finger of Death and brings down Breen in the meantime. Techies is going to go ahead and re-mine all of these towers now. Doing the same thing for each one, just dropping a whole bunch of remote mines in front of him. He still has a decent stack of landmines and this one odd one up here that really has no purpose. Almost think he should try to bait someone up and get rid of that. Schubert, meanwhile, taking a lot of damage from Taliban, just chasing in, diving right on in for this one. One more slow will get him up, and now they rupture him. They can run over the mines, but they won't die to them. And Taliban will bring down Schnurber. Hazardous is in there, though. Has a Finger of Death, but doesn't have enough mana to use it. Tries to go ahead with the mana drain, but not going to be quite enough to do what he needs to accomplish. Meanwhile, Purge in the bottom lane looks like he was getting a little cheeky on the wave. Exactly. Farming up has got his Butterfly. So he's pretty much accelerating in farm right now. The Radiance, again, it's like a regular Radiance would be, but it does help you farm. Not sure if it helps PL specifically farm. It can take down camps really crazily, but I think it's giving this sort of this mind games to him, where it's like, I've got a Radiance, it's farming time. And that's exactly what he should be doing. That's 100% the right play here, and he's doing a lot by farming. His team is also creating a little bit of space here. Ashka, Asura, running low. He's running away and forcing the Dire to just kind of chase him around. Tits will finally go ahead and close in on him. Will bring him down, but now he might actually fall because of it. Breen's going to continue chasing on him. He has a track ready to go. Does he throw it, though? It looks like he's holding on to it for now. Throws out the track. Hazardous comes on in, though. And it will slow him down. Meanwhile, Exactly pushing it out. No one dying just yet. Scared will finally bring down Tits McGee, though. And might be able to do more. Hazardous trying to chase onto the bounty, but can't quite bring him down. And oh no, Exactly! He'll get knocked down on their treat. And these mines proving to be just too much for the Radiant. I'm not sure if he's getting Bloodstone charges for each and every time he kills someone across the map, but I wouldn't be surprised. Purge will push in through the top lane, maybe trying to put some tower damage on this tower. Smart play here. Just trying to continue to get objectives. Though he's going to run into a little bit of trouble, might have to back himself off really shortly. Hazardous is in close by. They try to silence, but he's going to phase shift out. Hazardous now goes in for Taliban. He's got his Finger of Death. They got plenty of damage, but can they unleash it enough? No, he's going to go into his silence. Finger of Death comes out onto Scared. But Purge, taking so much, he'll go down. Hazardous as well. An RP comes through, but he misses on the Shockwave. Will go for the Skewer, though. Finds a kill regardless. And now Breen pops the BKB. Rupture down onto Schnurber. And Schnurber ends up going down. Tits McGee also in a little bit of trouble. Radiant, find three. They could find more here. Tits McGee on the run. And this could be the 4-for-3 that they were looking for here. All right now, they're trading evenly, but even that they're happy about. So it looks like because of that, they'll back off. They don't want to chase anymore. Instead, they want to go back, try to find some creeps and find some farm. But As a result of that fight, we've pretty much hit equilibrium for gold. Experience now down to about 15,000 advantage, which 47 minutes, even a 10,000 advantage is just nothing. 15,000 advantage is nothing. So we're approaching the late game here where things, the only thing that matters are buybacks and individual items, like how each person is itemizing. You can have a 10,000 gold disadvantage, but still have everyone be nearing the six slotted. I mean, it's just an item difference at some point in the game, and at when it gets late enough for carries, it's even not even that. Like you're sitting as a carry on like 10,000 gold, and I mean, of course, you know, buying sentries for everyone and making use of that gold, I guess. But Techie's dropping down the minefield sign. What's the range on it? Yeah, it's only 125 radius around the sign, so these mines are revealed. The minefield sign does not hide them. But it isn't really making a difference because the Radiant aren't really prioritizing keeping vision around them so they know where the mines are anyway. We can take a look around and see if anyone has any like sentry wards or anything. And it looks like on the Radiant side, no sentry wards, no dust, no nothing. So that might be one thing that could easily win the game, is just going for that. Cutie Vomit, trying to run away, going for the TP, but will end up be the death of her. No, it won't. Gets away with one HP or just about left. Meanwhile, on top lane, it looks like Puck is going to go ahead, bring down Bounty Hunter. They want Ashka Asura as well. The Rupture comes out, and he's running way too damn fast. Blinks forward, hexes out, but it's a fast frog. Can they skewer? Can they impale? Can they do anything? They will bring him down, but in comes Exactly, looking for the return kill. On to Hazardous, doing lots of damage, but not quite able to chase him down. No, they are. They continue on to him, throw off the Spirit Lance and bring him down. Meanwhile, Purge could be in his equal amount of trouble. In comes Taliban. They bring him down. Scared isn't as well, but they can't find Schnurbert. So he'll get himself away. But another trade, another decent trade at that for the Radiant. Seemed like they would have lost that one, but coming in and returning the favor in that one. Now, they've got to be very, very careful, because if they get wiped by mines here, this game goes on another 20 minutes. And it looks like they might do just that. They're all grouped up. Oh, no. Taliban will make his way up to the tower, but Becky's... Oh, he is going to pop it. All right. So Taliban is gone. That means all the mines are gone. And Exactly can go ahead and push off this one. He'll bring down some creeps. Looking for Tits McGee here. Does a significant amount of damage to him. And should actually bring him down. They're going to go ahead and pop the Lincoln Sphere so the Spirit Lance can come through. And Tits McGee, he is as good as dead. Meanwhile, Nature's Prophet getting brought down. And Exactly trying to go after this tower, but will get hit by the Stasis Trap. Yule Scepter up. Another Stasis to hit the ground. And Exactly doesn't want to continue fighting. Instead, backs off, despite being able to probably go ahead and just bring him down. So, still no objectives being taken in this game. But we got our closest ever to get to Arrax going down. That's a plus for this one. So, Exactly makes his way back towards the middle lane. He's got a decent amount of HP, but not a whole hell of a lot. I think he really wants Vlads to be finished, but no, Drought doesn't even finish the Vlads. Instead, is sitting on a naked Morbid Mask. Oh man, that's unfortunate. Thank you. So, looks like Radiant might be doing a little bit of a group in mid, trying to push down, but I guess looks like not. They're going back and they're farming it up. Exactly. Might be going for a Mantis Tail. In fact, he's got it if he wants it. He could just outright buy it, but holding on to the 33 or 3100 gold here. Guess that's 10 in a row. And okay, another techies kill, another 200 or so gold, 300 or so gold for the techies. Purge, meanwhile, pushing out, but he could be in a lot of trouble here. Do they have a silence? Do they have anything to bring him down? No, they've got a basher. Nature's Prophet's got a basher. Okay, they're going to silence Purge. They're just going to bring him down. Understanding. All right. So this is a Nature's Prophet basher. So even, I mean, it's like, what, 10% chance on ranged heroes? Yeah, 10% chance for ranged heroes to bash, but a bash is a bash. So I guess he's alright with that. Techie's still mining up, though, and doing a very good job at that. Keeping the lanes so that they can't push in completely, or if they do, you at least eliminate one of the creep waves, so that has to be delayed a little bit longer. That's the problem with Techies. One mine with Aghanims destroys a creep wave. So that's exactly what he's got. I mean, what is that, 600, 750 damage? Yeah. That's a pretty hefty amount of damage. I mean, judging by a creep is only about 500 HP. 600 HP, yeah. That. So it looks like the mines might go down soon. Ashka Asura was within range. But he's going to hold on to them for the time being. Just waiting for multiple units to get caught in it. Just like that, Radiant will hold back for now. Waiting for the next creep wave. Another day, another dollar here. And another minefield sign that's not really doing anything. They need to be within the, like, 125 radius is small. It's like melee radius. So Zachary trapped underneath the mines. And they might just bring him down here. No, they're going to bring him down with regular auto attacks. He needs to go ahead and doppel walk out of this one. Does he have it, though? No, he's stunned up from the Dream Coil. So he'll go down. Not a single mine was popped. Scared trying to back away from this one. Can he actually get out? He will. Meanwhile, Green, they've got the dust onto him. They've got full vision of him, and they'll start to try to bring him down. Stealing all of his mana. The dust ends soon, but the Dagon comes through. And a 4 for nil for the Dire. This turtle proving to be way too damn much for the Radiant to handle. I mean, they're farming pretty well, too, which is rather good. Oh, what's this? The back door, scared. He wants it. He wants it. He wants the back door, but he can't hit it fast enough. Oh, man, this is...
Dire's top tower.
This is hilarious. Okay. There's a point where you should realize that you can't do this and then stop trying. I think we're a little past that point. So he's going to try a TP out. The Waning Rift actually misses. He might get away. No, he's not. All right. The cheeky backdoor attempt meets utter disappointment and despair. Meanwhile, the mid-racks are taking a lot of damage here. There's a buyback on the Nature's Prophet. This mid-racks could be very devastating for them, but looks like... I mean, with Ashka Asura, they might be able to defend this one. No, Hazardous goes straight on in. Goes to the Hex on the Ashka.
Radiant's mid-rags taking some punishment.
And he'll back himself away. Taliban is in, though. This is the major damage dealer for them. Can he make anything happen? Can he defend these racks? It looks like he can. But this is the kicker. All this time, the Techies has been doing this. And Taliban might actually drop here. No, Taliban's going to live. Anyone go down? Breen could go down. Ashka, Asura could also go down. All three could go down. No! Wait, no, never mind. They weren't attacking the mines there. Kind of fixated on this one, because someone could go down. 750 damage a mine. Okay, never mind. Interesting, but not going to be able to grab anyone. 56 minutes in this game, 37 to 67. Dire having every advantage in the kill score, but... In terms of gold, they've actually picked it back up with the golden experience lead. Back down to 20,000 plus experience lead. Back down to about 5,000 net worth lead. And the Radiant, despite farming, having the top net worth on their side. They're just, the rest of their heroes just don't seem to be farming nearly as well. And, I mean, PL, where does he go from here? Maybe he goes into Scotty to pick up some extra stats. Maybe he goes into Daedalus to pick up some extra damage. Regardless, he's got... a lot of time before he even needs to really worry about his position in this game, because he's just knocking down people. The main issue about him, though, is he's a little squishy, so he's got to be very careful about his positioning, doppelwalk almost excessively whenever they throw something at you. But for right now, he's going to go ahead, split push up the top lane. Now, there is a huge mind stack here now. But the middle, yep, there's a huge mine stack in middle as well. What about bottom? Yeah, okay, so just like that. Oh, God. Radiant need to be very, very careful about how they play this one. So they're going to send. PL illusions up. trying to do some damage to Purge. They've got lots of spawning here. They're going to go ahead and clear out the landmines, but that's about it.
The dire best do meanwhile, about that bottom
they
tower.
Denied the tier 3 tower. Dyer's bottom tier 3 taking some damage from Scary, but he's scared off right now. He's not going to continue going for it, despite it only being really Cutie Vomit Girl that's coming in to defend it. So he's dropping down the mines up. Techies will go ahead and bring down Pandem Lancer in the top lane. Buys back, though. Should be coming back into this one. There's a rupture out, but it doesn't really mean anything. And Dyer. Well, they'll win that fight for now, but... Alibon. That hurts. That hurts to imagine what could have just happened there. But the reality of it is, nothing. Nothing happens. Maybe on the way out, if they could force him to step back. The Taliban just goes straight on in. Now he's going to walk back, but he's invisible walking over the mines. No, he turns around. Breen wants to go in. Tits McGee could be the target, but they're still not taking that much damage. In goes Breen. Up goes Breen. Array goes Breen. And down goes Breen. Meanwhile, Scared, trying to continue pushing. Taliban! Ugh. Oh my god. That's just... painful to watch how close he's come to dying. Zachary, though, he bought back for this. He goes down. He's in major trouble. He's got double walk. He suspend it. He will do so, but he can't get out from this one anymore. He tries to turn around, tries to fight. Hazard's taking a lot of damage, and he will not get the kill. Meanwhile, Nature's Prophet could have been up top, maybe trying to split push out these racks, but for the time being, just seems like Radiant unsure of how they want to push this one. Meanwhile, Taliban... Oh, man. Okay, so he's far enough away from the secret shop that he's not going to actually walk over this mine. But I'm going to keep an eye on him regardless, because... you can never be too sure. So I'm not exactly positive as to what this is and what's going on here, but there are two soul boosters in Taliban's inventory. And he's going to go on to Tits McGee, goes for the silence, lots of damage coming out from that double damage rune. And he'll bring down Tits McGee, just needs one more crit, doesn't even need it. He'll bring him down. Hazardous now will turn around, go for the Hex, but he's too damn tanky, those two Soul Boosters, giving him a grand total of 900 HP. 900 HP and 800 mana for this Drow Ranger. I guess if you want to tank up, buy Soul Boosters. But holy mind stack, they're both going to die. Jesus. Every time I see that, every single time I'm going to, like, hold my breath. Sherbert, can he stalk him into mines? He won't. Now Taliban, he's got a double RP. Can he spend it, though? He's got enough mana for it. And they, again, don't pop mines. These mines are just kind of sitting here doing nothing. Hits. Meanwhile, Purge is going for that whole split push deck again.
Radiant's top tower's hurting.
Radiant Vomit Girl, mining up the bottom lane. Ashka, Sirka, taking a lot of damage here. He might actually just go down. Schnerber, he's got the BKB, blood right on the ground. Rupture out. If he can get the kill, it's huge, but he cannot seem to find it. But Taliban hitting from the low ground will find it on to Hazardous. Schnerber trying to run away. Breen is on the chase. They've got the rupture onto him. He can't quite run. Maybe he can now. Maybe he can lure them into the mines. He will, but the mines won't kill anyone. Meanwhile, Zachary will find a kill on the puck, but the main action just went down mid, and just like that, 61 minutes in, and the Radiant once again opened up with a little bit of an opportunity to push, but they need some way to deal with these mines, and it doesn't seem like they're putting that much effort into it. McGee will just kind of move forward. Not sure what his plan was there, but he gets some decent damage out onto the Bounty Hunter before walking back. Meanwhile, Vomit Girl is just mining everything. Has an Octarine Core, so just is throwing mines down like they're candy. And look, pretty much regenning back from each mine too, so the Bloodstone is definitely paying off here. Has 17 landmines. Pretty decent. All of the mines are going up to this top lane, though. I guess Nature's Prophet is yelling at Drow to take towers, maybe? Wrong team. Whatever. In the meantime, Dire still defending really well. Radiant struggling to push us. 3,000 gold on the PL. What's he going to buy here? He goes for the reroll. Okay, so he's going straight into the heart. Going for the Difecta, I guess. Not the trifecta would be heart, butterfly, and sheepstick, but heart and butterfly, two of the three. Not bad. Breen makes his way in, looking for Tits McGee, but not going to find him. Meanwhile, all the Radiant pushing down the bottom lane, and Dire converging on them. They've got to be very aware of these mines. Very aware of them. RP comes through. Can he push him into mines? He won't. He'll push him instead to the left. Exactly comes in, though. They've got the Sprout on him. Mines will start to fly, but not nearly enough. In comes Hazardous, looking for some hexes, looking for some kills, but he's actually just going to go down. In the meantime, Schnurber also goes down. Exactly, though, trying to chase. Do they chase the high ground? Chasing it could be problematic. They will go down. More mines will blow up, but they're all gone now. And they'll heal themselves back up. Meanwhile, Vomitgirl is just mining everything right back up again, dropping the massive stack. The Octarine Core proving to be a little bit too much to handle. And with that all said and done, it looks like, oh, the Finger of Death, not enough. Or is it? Hazardous again going in for the exit of the Earth Spike, but not enough either. He's still chasing, though. Manta Style pop and send it back onto Hazardous. They might be able to find a kill here. But now Hazardous will stop the chase. Just like that. Double Bloodstone for the Drow Ranger. Alright. 1,000 health added to her HP pool. No stats, but just 1,000 health. Just interesting, to say the very least. I don't know, we're 65 minutes into this game, guys, and top lane literally looking like a giant red blob. It's all mines everywhere. Or the Dire side, rather. And Radiant, I mean, they seem like they're struggling so hard for this one. Taliban might find Tits McGee here, but, I mean, they're just kind of avoiding each other. Meanwhile, the Courier. He wanted the Courier. Maybe if he had a blink, he could go ahead and try to find it again, but opts not to go for it, and Courier will survive. What is on, said Courier? That's a Vitality Booster, which is the remaining part, or nearly the remaining part, for Phantom Lancer's heart. He just needs a recipe, and he is good to go. So they'll start their push up top, but top lane has got to be the scariest in terms of mines. Middle lane? Okay, they're fine. They're all really scary. Techies, you quite humble this game, are we? Zachary will lead the charge. Can they finally break a base, or break a Raxxir? Doing so against mines is just so stressful for them. They've got to be careful. They've got to be really in tune with this one. It's going to be a stasis trap, and it's going to stop Breen. Nope, do they have a gem? Do they have a gem? Do they finally have some vision? They do! They've got a gem! Oh my god, this is perfect for them. They need to do this. Unfortunately, the RP, it's gonna pull them back into the mines! Does he do it? No, he doesn't! Given the opportunity, just win the game there. And he doesn't do it. Or maybe he still has. There's gonna be a push in mid. Can they bring down these racks? It looks like now they're going to chase up the high ground. Do they still have that gem? The gem's down. Are they going to die here? Oh, no. The techies is not blowing up the mines. Finally blows them up. But they're all down now, or pretty much all down. And Taliban is left to blow up the rest of the racks. No. Zachary's gone. Taliban still alive. But just barely, the ranged racks go down, but the melee racks still standing. Hazardous, meanwhile, laying into the Radiant side's racks. Oh my lord.
Something bad's happened to the Radiant's courier.
And who's courier? Radiant's courier? Goes down. That is the vitality booster that dropped and the gem of true sight.
Radiant's bottom racks, it's hurting.
Oh my lord. The Radiant just getting played like a fiddle there. Though not quite ideal. I still think the Magnus RP pulling them back into the mines would have been the ideal play. Regardless, it buys time. The Radiant lose their mid-racks, and they get the Tier 3 bottom destroyed and some chip damage on the bottom racks. So Radiant are struggling so hard right now. And a lot of faith is being put in this Techies Magnus combo. As makes sense, the Techies and the Magnus have been doing an amazing job defending this one so far. Skurd is going to go straight up on top, but I don't think he finds this one. In fact, I don't think he does anything here. Vomit Girl is doing a great job at keeping this wave from pushing in and keeping the racks protected. Meanwhile, Hazardous has a double damage. Caliban could be in a little bit of trouble. In fact, it's McGee and Purge are all going to go in. Strawber is there as well, or Newbert, whatever. And they lose vision. She has a Shadow Blade going for the Silver Edge, but lots of mines being blown up in the bottom lane here. Lots of creeps dying. Lion will go ahead, bring down Scared. Okay, that's an awkward place for Nature's Prophet to be. And Radiant slowly but surely losing grip of this game. Purge going in for the Dagon on Exacary, but he's got a hard to rest as soon as his courier comes back alive. Now Purge trying to get himself away, but it's going to be the Fast Spirit Lance. Probably could have jaunted to his Illusory Orb, but Zachary in a little bit of trouble. They've got a lot to bring him down. They will. 130 seconds without a PL. Caliban doing what he can. But Hazardous could just blink up, hex him, and maybe try to find a kill here. And that's exactly what happened. Blink forward, hex out. Machines really getting antsy here. All right, there they go. To the end of the world to them. They have fought, you know, what is that? Inherited Destiny? No. Manifest Destiny. Crossing the board, crossing the entire map. I don't know. Something like that. Something from history. Hazardous going to get erupted here. But Astra Asura getting blown to bits by Tix McGee. Snoober's there as well. But in comes Caliban. Maybe trying to bring down Hazardous finally. Will do so. Green's trying to fight. Schnurber's trying to fight them both. Tiz McGee is just standing there doing whatever he needs to do and bringing both Breen and Caliban in a lot of pain. So Dire will continue to push down the bottom lane. 70 minutes in, and there's still 50 seconds without APL on the map. 60 without a Bloodseeker. All Dire needs to push is right here. They don't have to worry about Techie's mines. They don't have to worry about anything like that. Meanwhile, Techie's is just nothing can happen to his base. Lion will buy back. Taliban's there ready to go. But Schnurber does have an RP ready if he needs to spend it. And it looks like the silence will come out. But creeps will be the one to be targeted here. And so the racks, well, they will fall. Meanwhile, Caliban running away, but can't quite get away. Can he live? He will live off this one, but just barely. Schnurber, maybe pulling a bit too far ahead, will end up going down because of this really aggressive maneuver. Purge as well. He heals himself back up, and does he have an Illusory Orb and Jaunt to get away? He does. He'll actually end up blinking. Tiz McGee, the silence. Hazardous is there, but lots of damage coming out. Purge comes back in. Maybe he doesn't. Zachary is there. So Dire will escape. They bring down the racks, and that says that. I mean, having two racks up, certainly something that you want to say, but 17-2 minutes in, does it really matter all that much? There are plenty of Maelstrom's Lightning Procs, you know, Mjolnir's out on the side of the Radiant. They could easily push these waves out. So I think they need to get their Mega Creeps out very soon. Looks like they should be able to do so, even if they lose a fight. I mean, as far as buyback goes, There are two buybacks in the field. Dire has none of them. But they do have Techie's Mines guarding their base. Rupture comes out. Honda Schnurbert. Tits McGee is in, though, and not really giving a care to the world. He's blinking forward. Hazardous is there as well. And Ashka Asura taking way too much damage. Gets blown to bits. Of course, you know, it's not showing the kill for some reason for me. But with the Bloodseeker going down, that is a real problem for the Radiant side. Missing their Bloodseeker again for 80 seconds as the Dire begin to push in mid. Constantly pushing in. They need to group up with their top lane, and it looks like they're not actually going to go for the push yet. Instead, perhaps Roshan? Yep, it looks like Sean. My god, this Techies must be having a ball right now. Look at this. Look at all the mines coming out. I mean, there can only be 20 remote landmines, but hold on, Purge is in a lot of trouble. We'll go down here. Alright, to be expected. He was kind of pushing solo, but I wonder if I could, like, count the amount of entities that are remote mines on this map. I mean, I know there are 18 landmines. Okay. Interesting. 19 landmines on this map. And Radiant will begin to push themselves in. Maybe finally we might see a conclusion to this game. 75 or 74 minutes in. Exactly. Looking pretty. I mean, he can get rid of his Acolyph or something else. His net worth is rather low for a 74-minute game. I mean, you could take a look at the CS, and we're well below 10 CS a minute on anyone. It looks like Breen and Exactly. They push themselves in, but they're alone here in the mid lane. Scared is also alone in the top lane, and there's no way they can get creeps anywhere close to the base. You can see, yeah, just getting them nuked before they even get within backdoor protection reduction, so. This is a pretty problematic game for the Radiant. Despite having, I mean, we'll say what leads they've got. Yeah, they've got a 5,000 gold lead. Still lacking on experience, but all in all, not too bad. They're just, you know, struggling so damn hard to find what they need to find here. So, as it stands right now, again, 75 minutes. I agree with Pink here. This is looking to be insanity. Can Dire defend one more time, though, versus the Radiant Onslaught? Looks like they might have no problem. They move around to the bottom lane, but they're going to die in mines here. Or at least he's going to get... Okay, so they're going to wait this time, waiting for more. A lot of remote mines or landmines being brought down here. More landmines going down, and just like that, Ashka Asura will go down. Purge goes in. In comes one RP, but it doesn't connect. Instead, the silence comes out mid-RP cast. Purge gets himself up. Meanwhile, more mines dropping. More people probably dying here. Taliban still alive. It looks like they're trying to split push this one out, but they can't seem to find it. And so Radiant will pull back for the time being. Still Taliban and Breen in the top lane. Still Exactly in the mid. And they bring down the PL, by the way. Hazardous goes in. Finds the Earth Spike. Exactly will turn around. Looks on a Purge. Purge in a lot of trouble. Will yules himself back up, but he's most certainly dead here. TP's himself away, but cannot complete said TP. Hazardous, meanwhile, will go for the Finger of Death. But in comes the Spirit Lance, doing plenty of damage. Can he go down here? He pops into Ghost Scepter, which is taking more damage from the Radiance. And all the mines are pretty much going down the mid lane. Vomit Girl trying to keep them back up. Just like that, PL will push everything. The mines! So close. Amago goes in. They get the RP. The Skewer, or the Shockwave misses. The Skewer does connect, though. Exactly well out of it. Breen well out of it. Another missed Shockwave. And Exactly going to go ahead and chase now into Schnurbert. Goes into Hazardous as well. The Finger of Death misses entirely. And Hazardous dropping very low. And the Ghost Scepter, which only boosts the damage coming out from the Shuriken Toss. Now Schubert will get another RP off, but pushes them again away from the mines. And Exactly, we'll turn around, start to bring down Schubert here. It looks like Exactly is well past the mine threshold now. Gonna bring down one. Looks for Vomit, but ends up going towards the bottom lane where the Rax has gone down. Wait. Rax is gone on bottom. That means that Radiant only have one more Rax to bring down. Dire also have one Rax to bring down. Tiss McGee doing what he can to push it out. Here, do we see double Mega Creeps here? We might very well. A Suicide comes out from our Techies who immediately buys back. Tinker, meanwhile, going onto these Rax. This will be Mega Creeps if we can finish them out. And he gets it. One range, or one melee. The range also should go down here. He might YOLO for it, but at this point, it's going to be Mega versus Mega. Maybe it isn't. He gets the Mega Creeps. Tiss McGee's down here doing what he can to try to turn around. The Megas actually do go out. But Zachary, he doesn't care about Megas. He just wants to end the game, but he's ending it against two. So there he goes. Into the melee racks here. Trying to do what he can. Will bring down Hazardous as they spawn some Mega Creeps of their own. Zachary might be in a little bit of trouble here. Brings down Purge. There's a dagger that comes out, but it's off the mark. Zachary looking for Hazardous, but the Finger of Death! Oh no! And now a second set of Mega Creeps will be coming out. Megas versus Megas. But as it stands right now, Radiant, the only one with people alive. Tiss McGee doing what he can to defend. But it looks like Zachary's just going to walk up and slap him. Slap him, Sillery. That one 10% bash chance does come out. And now everyone's dead on Dire. Radiant, it looks like they've done it. Oh, wait, no, they don't have Mega Creeps. They still got the top lane of Rax, so... yeah. Radiant haven't quite done it yet. They're still kind of waiting. Waiting the world to change here. Exactly. Okay, there we go. Just be careful. They're going to pop mines, but that's about it. He'll go for the Megas. He'll get the Megas. They still... Nature's Prophet dies to the... I just don't know, guys. I really don't know. Radiant haven't won yet. Mega Creeps on both sides of the map. I mean, this is the first time I think I've seen this happen. Very first time. Oh, unfortunately, we don't get to see the Mega Creeps clash in the mid lane just yet. We will, though. We will see them. Courier?
The Radiant's courier didn't make it.
No, I want to see the Mega Creeps clash. Green, let them clash. There we go. Clash of the Mega Creeps. Right here, right now. Techies, I think he just needs to delay as long as possible. He's mining everything up right now. Taliban gonna get stunned by the stasis trap. They got plenty of damage. Can they bring him down? It looks like they very well can. RP comes out. And Drow goes down. But the Bloodstone, keeping her from dying, I guess, staying dead a relatively long time. So she'll buy back. Buyback available on Nature's Prophet. And Tiss McGee pushed out the bottom lane. Mega Creeps are moving in. Some of their own Mega Creeps are also pushed in, or are going to spawn very soon. I think this is rather hilarious. Megas versus Megas. Boom. And the top lane, okay, guys, I have to admit, I'm a little frazzled after this game. Oh, no! Cutie Vomit Girl pops all the mines, and then gets them all just...
Radiant's mid-tower could use a hand.
Very unfortunate. Exactly is still there. Mega Creeps are pushing into the base, though. Radiant are losing their base not entirely fast. It looks like all the Mega Creeps are down. Exactly will go ahead and grab a kill here. Actually, no, it's Exactly that goes down. The Tier 4 is still standing. The bases are almost exact mirror images of each other right now. Exactly. Oh, my God. Tiss McGee will probably drop here. Oh, jeez. Tiss McGee is actually still alive. Scared is going to go ahead and bring him down, though. Lash of the Megas. Interesting stuff, guys. I don't know. Let's just look at this for a little bit. Nothing much interesting is happening right now. I don't know what to say. I really just don't know what to say here. Mega creeps or not, I mean, it doesn't even matter anymore. There's no possible way for any team to make their push stronger. 92-62 is an 83-minute game right now. And it looks like the Radiant, they'll begin to push themselves in. Looking for that final push. I don't even know what's happening here. But they make their way up. Lots of mines on the ground. Yvonne, the girl, she's going to go ahead. Gets ruptured up, but she's got plenty of mines across. Looks like she might blow some of them up. And they're starting to blow, and they will go ahead and grab Asuka or Ashka. In comes the RP. They have a second one. They don't even have a second one. Shockwave's up in just a second. They will go ahead. They bring down Exakari. Scared goes in. He finds one, but he's going to go down as well. Three already gone on the side of the Radiant. Breen trying to get away, but Tits McGee will continue chasing, or at least tries to continue chasing. Illusion Rub comes out. Purge looking for more. Taliban doing what he can, I guess, kind of AFKing. Buys a... Oh, dear Lord. Rapier on the deck. 83 minutes in, the first Rapier purchased of the game. And so begins the defense of the Rapier, of the tower. The best tower in the game. The Drow Ranger Tower. Just sit right here. Sit right here and 8-click. Mega creeps mean nothing right now. I've never seen a game like this before. I've never seen a game where both teams got mega creeps. And I guess there's a first for everything. But this is just incredible. Incredible. Alright, so Taliban, he's got the rapier. He needs to defend with a rapier. Gotta be careful though. If he gets RP'd, he's in a lot of trouble. 1715 is his crit. 1700. He's gonna go in, drops a silence on a Tits McGee, chases down. But even with the rapier, his damage just doesn't seem to be that much. The hex comes out, blood around the ground, rapier, it could hit the deck, but no, his team keeps him alive. Ashka Asura will finally go down though. Breen, the RP hits onto him. Drow Ranger, meanwhile, coming in, wants some more kills, but all in all, is still alive, still kicking. Can she defend against this onslaught of mega creeps, though? Doesn't have any lifesteal. They need a Vlad on their team. Tier 4 will go down. Ancient is exposed. And Taliban needs to defend against this. He is their only tower. And is doing what he can. It looks like he will go ahead and be successful with it.
Things ain't looking bright for Radiant's Ancient.
But Radiant's Ancient being this exposed right now. Whereas the Dyers, I wouldn't call that exposed at all. I wouldn't call that anywhere close to exposed. So, 85 minutes in, 65-96. I think the Dyer have won, but I can't be sure. If Radiant, I don't even think Radiant can win this. They have to push so damn well. But these mines are just going to destroy them. Do they have a gem? I guess would be the big thing. Yes, they do. Okay, they've got a gem. You can't minefield sign all of this, so maybe Radiant have a shot here. But they have to win the fight, they have to clear the mines, and they have to bring down the Ancient. So they'll go ahead and make their push up. The Drow Ranger holding back into the base, being their one point of defense. I think the Drow Ranger needs to be with this push, but if they lose the Rapier, they automatically lose anyway, so they gotta be very careful. Scare's gonna go in, pops out the Wrath of Nature, in comes what seems to be the Drow Ranger. No, it's Ashka Asura, but all the mines will get popped and scared. He's gonna go down, Breen is gonna go down, they're all dead to the mines that they knew were there with the gem.
Cashing out.
Oh, boy. So, that might be it. Drow Ranger has to defend alone. Against Megas, against four. Everyone pushing into the bottom lane. Drow makes her way down. We'll go for the silence. Tries to bring down Tits McGee. Doing some decent damage, but again, no lifesteal is making it very difficult on her. And so, The final attempt at defense. Jeez, that's so hard to say. It doesn't look like it's going to matter. The Radiant Ancient, in rather lackluster fashion, however, after one hell of a game, will finally go down. Purge, no, he's dead. Taliban, he's chasing. He wants Tits McGee, he wants Vomit, but the stasis trap locks him in place. Maybe now he can continue to defense. It looks like he will single-handedly defend this game. Breen will buy back. Maybe not. In comes Swamper. They've got RPs. They've got everything. They'll bring him down. Ancient, or a Divine Rapier hits the deck. And the Ancient will finally drop. GG, well played. I think I have to take a bit of a break after that one, guys. But for right now, if you wouldn't watch through the entire thing, you're a trooper. If you watch the entire thing, you're a trooper. Live or as it's a replay, guys. So thank you very much for watching. We'll be back again shortly for more of the Golden Aegis Cast series. For right now, we're going to take a quick break. We'll catch you all next time.